assembled. Let me just express my gratitude to everybody that is reassembling behind me, to everybody that assembled 45 or so days ago in this special session. We don't enter into special sessions lightly. I know how challenging these experiences are for all of us, but notably for those that are entrusted to advance that process. So let me start by expressing deep gratitude to the pro tem and the speaker that have been extraordinary partners since they've ascended into their respective roles across a myriad of issues, but have been particularly supportive of the process that ultimately unfolded here. We can get consumed by the circulinear nature of that process unfolding, but there was no question in my mind, there was no doubt in my mind that we would be back here as we were a year or so ago in advancing the cause that we had advanced with the original special session. I made this point a year ago, I'll make it again today. And it's in the spirit of what the pro tem just said. Success as it relates to addressing the issue of prices in this state, gas prices in particular, is not a process or rather a destination itself, meaning there is no having made it. It's something that unfolds over the period of time. There's humility in that process. There's a deep understanding that this is not the final word as it relates to the issue of gas prices in the state of California, quite the contrary. But what we were able to do last year allowed us to see underneath the proverbial tent, to look in and rather insert a point of view, to truly understand and validate a point of view, and ultimately understand that one of the principal issues that was holding back our capacity to tame these price spikes was the issue around supply, issues around maintenance, issues around refineries. And we're here today because of the progress we made a year or so ago. And that progress continues now with the CEC. Remember, this bill basically now allows for a secondary process to unfold at the California Energy Commission to assess this market, to consider what those supply demands are, to consider all the health and human service issues that were brought up during these 20 hours of testimony, to bring up worker safety issues, to bring up the concerns that were expressed around costs, indirect or direct, to expose a lot of the mistruths and manipulation on the other side, particularly WISPA and their talking points, and Big Oil, that knowingly continues to lie to the people of this state, our nation, for that matter, around the world. They are the polluted heart of this climate crisis. They continue to lie, and they continue to manipulate. And they're taking advantage of you. And this should be universal. 37 million gallons a day are purchased in the state of California, and they have been raking in unprecedented profits because they can, because they take advantage of you. They take advantage of emotion. They take advantage of the fact they have a massive economic advantage. They buy their manipulation. Politicians, industry groups, front groups, organizations that are created out of thin air, dark money that they put in, and they've been fleecing you for decades and decades, billions and billions and billions of dollars. Hardworking people, just as the speaker said, just trying to make ends meet, get to work, take care of their kids, and they're screwing you. They've been screwing you for years and years and years. There's no other way to put it. You can't sugarcoat this. And they lied again over the course of the last few weeks. And they'll continue to lie. And what I'm so proud of is that we stood up. We didn't step back. Everybody here had the courage of their convictions. And they stood tall. It wasn't easy. I mean, we saw what happened here. You see it over and over and over and over again. You see it all across the country. But what you don't see happening across the country is the kind of courage that these folks behind me demonstrated. So to the authors, some of them are Hart, Agra Curry, Senator Skinner, and every one of the folks that were entrusted in this special session to stand tall, to ask the tough questions. Thank you for asking the tough questions, to stress test this idea. Thank you for having the backs of hardworking people in this state. It's about time. Big oil does not have your back, period. Full stop. This is not complicated. It's right and wrong. I've been lying to you year in, year out. Price of crude oil goes down. There's no increase. No increase in taxes. You're seeing gas prices drop across the rest of the country, but spike in California. And they buy all these ads saying somehow it's California's fault. They've been manipulating you. They've been lying to you. They've been playing you over and over and over again. And every single one of you, every single person reporting on this, every single person in front of the camera, behind the camera, you have been screwed by these companies. Not complicated. And forgive me for being so pointed. It's exhausting. And what's also exhausting, with all due respect, you know, I was walking with my kids yesterday out there on the coast in Inverness. And, we're trying to explain a little bit of what just happened in Florida over and over and over and over and over and over and over again. This is all connected. It's not complex. Places, lifestyles, tradition. We had an ex-president of the United States threatening once again firefighters, emergency response, just down in Southern California just 48 hours ago, threatening with a related cost. Talk about, again, a polluted mindset. And I don't know. You couldn't pay me enough to regurgitate the talking points of WISPA. The hell, why do people need to do that? Don't they care about their kids and grandkids, our future? Places, lifestyles, tradition. Ask the folks in Grizzly Flats, in Greenville, California. Well, I don't have to remind you of Paradise, California. Unprecedented heat waves every single damn year. Wake up. Talk about costs. They don't pay a damn penny as they socialize that pollution and that burden on generations. I think that former same president wanted $1 billion. That's all we need. Just $1 billion. He'll roll back all these regulations. That's how corrupt our system has become. And again, why I'm so damn proud of the folks in this rotunda in this room right now. So to every single one of you, I know this wasn't easy. I know it was a pain. I can only imagine the stuff you said behind my back. But I honestly think this is a point of pride, and it's a point of privilege that we had this opportunity, and we stood up. Let's not overstate this. Let's not overpromise here. Again, process that unfolds over time. But it's about time. It's about time we stood up. And I'll close on this. This is the fourth largest market in the world. This is a big damn deal. We're not some small isolated state. Fourth largest market in the world, right behind the United States, China, and Brazil. This is a big deal. And as was stated before, this is, I think Senator Skinner said it, a model for the nation. And I'll just close on that in the spirit of, you know, the Greeks. We do not imitate. We're proud, for we are a model to others. With that, we're here to answer any questions.